So about 10 months ago, I created a tutorial video explaining how to use the Inspect Element feature in Google Chrome to make editing your style sheets in Reddit super easy. I got a lot of positive feedback from that. A lot of people liked it. Unfortunately, it's pretty outdated now, as Reddit has drastically changed the way that they handle CSS and the way they output it. And Google Chrome has changed a lot of the ways that the Inspect Element feature works in Chrome. So I'm going to create an updated version of the video, which is what you're watching currently. So let's dive in with just the basics. If you right-click anywhere on a page, you're going to bring up the Inspect Element option. So click on that. And if this window pops up down here undocked, there's a little button at the bottom corner to dock it. There's four main parts of this. At the top, we have a couple different tabs, different sections. Here is the main code for the page as it's rendered. On the side is specific details about the line of code you have selected. And then at the bottom, we have a path showing the item you have selected and where that is and all of its parent elements. So this can be extremely useful, and this is just scratching the surface, but I'm going to go over some stuff with you. So, for example, if we were to right-click on the background up here, I want to change this from the default blue to something else, right-click and Inspect Element, and it's going to take me to header bottom left, and you'll see over in the sidebar it tells you all the information about this. You can scroll down and see everything that applies to it, and you'll see here is in the line of code. It shows that it has the CSS already applied to it that says font size large. If I uncheck this box, you'll see that in the header of the page, the font size is changing. But there's nothing in here talking about the background color. Now, I can add in a background color here, and it will change this, but that's not where it's actually set to. So it really doesn't matter if I add it here or in its parent element, which is header. So you can see down here at the bottom, there's the parent element header. That it does have a background color, and that is what's being changed. So if I uncheck that one, I'll see that is what's up there. So I can either add in a background element for header bottom left, or I can just alter the one for header. And what's neat is that it changes in real time. So if I wanted to change this to, say, a gray tone, I can type in CCC, and it updates instantly as I type it in, which is very helpful. So that lets you see in real time what it looks like, how that color has contrast with the other elements that are on the page in the same area, so on. Very helpful. Another thing that's really useful about this sidebar is elements that have a numeric value, like something that's in pixels or points. For example, this search bar on the side, when I have it selected, it shows me its information in the CSS. If I were to change, say, the padding or the border, the font size, or in this case, the width, just click on it once, it becomes selected, use your arrow keys. I'm just going to press the down arrow key, and you'll see that the number is going down, and at the same time, it's updating at the top. If I just hold it down, you'll see that this will update and show me in real time how big the numeric value I'm giving is actually showing up as. If I hold down shift and up or shift and down, then it will go up by increments of 10. So very, very useful to see things in real time rather than altering the width and then saving and refreshing the page to see if that's correct and if you need to adjust it, if you went too far or not enough. This you can see instantly if it's the right size or not. So very helpful, and that's with all numeric values. If I wanted to change the font size, for example, I can increment that down one pixel at a time or up. Very useful to see in real time so you get the exact size that you want for something. Now, where does this code go whenever you type it in here? You know, because as soon as I refresh this page, that stuff I changed, that background color, the font size for the search bar, those disappear. I'm only editing this in real time with the page. So the moment I refresh the page, those edits are gone. So where does it store these? Well, not in a very easy to get area. So although this is useful for a really quick thing, if you just need to change one value and then edit that in your style sheet, this is very useful. A more useful way of using this is to go over to the sources panel. And you'll see under Reddit static, the subreddit style sheet, there should be a long random file name in here. And that will contain all of the styles for this particular subreddit that were created by the moderators of it. So you'll notice that it's all compressed into one big line. And the reason for that is it's when you remove all of the spaces and unnecessary semicolons and returns, it's removing characters, which makes the file size smaller, uses less bandwidth, it downloads faster, has a lot of benefits. But for us, it's not very helpful because it's not very readable when it's all one big line like this. So you can ignore this if you just wanted to hit Control End on the keyboard and add a few returns in, and then add in something like pound header, and then give it a background color of like red or something. Then you would see that that does update in real time, and you can add your code, and when you're done, you can just copy this and then paste it into your style sheet. And that's something that I use quite often when I'm just making quick edits. However, sometimes it's useful, if you're going to be doing a lot of work, to be able to edit the original full version of the CSS without it being compressed. So there's a couple of things you can do for this. One is if you are not logged in, or you are looking at the style sheet for a subreddit that you do not mod, you're not a moderator of, you can go to about/stylesheet, and it will show you this page here, which has in it all of the code for that style sheet. And this is the page you get when you go to About Style Sheet and you're not a moderator or you're not logged in. And you can copy this and pretty effectively steal someone else's code and then paste that in to your subreddit, or use this for editing. Now, the problem that you would run into whenever you're copying from this page, or if you are logged in, you would see this page, this code. Same thing, you can just select all and copy it. The problem you run into is if, for example, you have a subreddit like this one where there is a lot of images in use, the code that you have to use in your style sheet to get this Argyle background or this Victorian background image up here is the name of the image surrounded by double percent signs. So you actually need to have the image uploaded and have the name named here and then referenced in this. Now, if you were to copy all this and then paste it into the sources window and inspect element, go to sources, select all and replace it with this, all those images are going to disappear because Chrome doesn't know what to do with this Reddit code. It doesn't understand what thumbs inside double percent signs is referencing. So you get a page without any images. Now, if your subreddit, like this one, only has one little glowy image behind the submit button and a background image, then that doesn't really matter so much. That's not a big deal, and you can just copy and paste that in and make your edits to adjust the colors and the sizes and widths of things very easily, and just keep it the original code that you had with all of the Reddit references in it. You could keep all of those and not have to worry about updating those later. But if you were to use something where you did have images like this gradient in the background here or this image in the sidebar, and you wanted to retain those while you're editing it, your other option is to select all of the code, this one big long line of compressed code, copy that, and go to a website like cleancss.com or any other CSS optimizer or cleaner out there. I'm just using this one as an example. Paste in the code that you copied, that one big long line. Change it so you want higher readability, and you don't want to change anything, you don't want to optimize anything, you want to turn off all the compression. You just want to make it so it's easy to read, from one big line of text to a bunch of stuff that's easy to read. Hit process, it will spit it out, and then just select all of it, copy, and you can come back, Control A, select that big long line that we just copied and uncompressed with clean CSS, paste in the uncompressed version, and nothing changed on the page because it's the exact same code just spread out. It just has a bunch of returns and spaces added in to make it easier to work with. So now, whenever you inspect element for something like, say, this background, this image here that's in the top corner of the winner for this week's stencil. You'll see exactly where it's located at. It's an H5. You'll see here in the sidebar it says dot size, dot user, text, dash body, H5, last of type A. This is exactly what is being targeted to create this image here at the top of the sidebar. And you'll see it shows the random characters, .css, the subreddit style sheet, and then line 695. So if I click on this, it'll take me to line 695 in the code. This is the same thing, and this is what I would be editing here in the sidebar, except it takes me to the full line of code here. So if I wanted to make changes here for something, whatever it may be, change the distance from the top, for example, if I make this a different number, then it would go in a different direction. I could see that updating in real time if I needed to make an adjustment there. And then I can just select the entire code and copy and paste it. Now, the problem is this version has the actual file paths to the images. So if I were to paste this back in to the subreddit's style sheet and hit save, Reddit would yell at me because it can't link to a full file path. It has to go to their version of the code, which has the double percent sign. So that's something you're going to have to, that's something you have to work around. And there's no getting around that. That's just the way that Reddit is set up, sadly. Another thing that you may run into is that the inspect element in Chrome shows you the full wealth of what Chrome is capable of doing. So that includes things that are not supported in Reddit. So certain things with CSS3, for example, like CSS3 animations or rotations, even some things related to shorthand for these rounded corners on objects, aren't supported. So although it will show up properly in Chrome in the inspect element window, when you go to paste it in, Reddit will give you errors and you'll have to fix those or remove that code. So that's something else to be aware of as well. There's no way of getting around that. That's just the way, that's just part of Reddit's limitations. So that's a pretty basic intro to inspect element. You'll obviously need to actually know CSS pretty well to use this effectively, but if you do know it, or if you're learning it, there's a lot of good resources. I'll put some links in the description of places you can learn CSS online for free. Then this can be a huge time saver and give you a lot of help. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. If this is helpful, if I should make another one of these in the future, if there's any more updates and this version gets outdated, let me know. Thanks, bye.